CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So let's join in Dhwani Shala class 6.
Hello learners of class 6. Welcome to the wonderful world of English language classroom. Learners, how are you all? You have now come to class 6. That means you are now in high school. Great. This means that you are growing and learning a lot. You must have got your new textbooks, notebooks, pen, pencil, and so on. Of course, your new good spirits of being in class 6. You are excited to learn many, many things in English, in your language, Hindi, Tamil, Malayalam, anything. Science, social science, and mathematics, and also to do physical education and many, many things. Learners, let me ask you one thing. How do you feel as a student of class 6? Meaning, you have come to high school, you are growing, you are learning. Think about it, reflect. Learners, with me here is a student like you, Sirat.
Hello everybody.
Oh, Sirat, how do you feel?
I feel great in this class 6th and a lot of homework.
Okay, homework also getting. Fine. This has some connection with the lesson we are going to do. Learners, get ready. We will listen to the lesson, understand the text, the story, then do some activity in this particular lesson. Okay, let me ask you, Siraj, and the learners there, do you like homework?
Yes, doing homework is fun.
Then, okay, do you like homework if it is given every day, so much homework?
That is not good. Sometimes we don't like homework, doing homework every day, and we get bored by doing the homework.
Fine. Okay. And mostly what kind of homework you get? Reading, writing?
Drawing.
And writing.
Yeah.
Mostly learners, I understand. I don't know the practice now. Schools have changed. Teachers have changed. They are giving homework to read and go around and collect some ideas and speak to parents and elders. But generally homework is assumed to be writing work. So, there is a mixed feeling of doing homework among children. And even teachers also feel, some teachers feel that we shouldn't be giving too much homework. I agree with that. And fine. Okay, now, here is a story of a boy who never wanted to do homework. There's a problem with him. He played and he is somewhat lazy. So, that lesson, who did Patrick's homework? So, I'm going to make you listen to the story, who did Patrick's homework? Then we will do some activities based on that. Sirat, ready? Come
yes.
On. Open your ears and listen to it. Learners, here is the story for you. Listen to it carefully.
Before you read, discuss in class. Do you like homework? Do you do it yourself? Or do you get help? What homework do you usually have? There are some new words in this box. Page 7. Nintendo, a video game. Ignoramus, an ignorant person who lacks education. 1. Patrick never did homework. Too boring, he said. He played hockey and basketball and Nintendo instead. His teachers told him, "Patrick, do your homework or you won't learn a thing." And it's true. Sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus. But what could he do? He hated homework. 2. Then one day he found his cat playing with a little doll and he grabbed it away. To his surprise, it wasn't a doll at all, but a man of the teeniest size. New words in the box, page 8. Breeches. Breeches or short trousers. The writer here spells it for fun, to rhyme with the word witches. Dishcloth. A cloth used for washing dishes. Hamper. A basket with a lid. Grimaced. Scowled. Pursed his lips. His face had these expressions showing disgust, anger, and disapproval. He had a little wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches and a high, tall hat, much like a witch's. He yelled, "Save me! Don't give me back to that cat! I'll grant you a wish. I promise you that." 3. Patrick couldn't believe how lucky he was. Here was the answer to all of his problems. So he said, "Only if you do all my homework till the end of the semester, that's 35 days. If you do a good enough job, I could even get A's." 4. The little man's face wrinkled like a dishcloth thrown in the hamper. He kicked his legs and doubled his fists, and he grimaced and scowled and pursed his lips. "Oh, I'm cursed, but I'll do it." Number 5. And true to his word, that little elf began to do Patrick's homework, except there was one glitch. The elf didn't always know what to do, and he needed help. "Help me, help me," he'd say. And Patrick would have to help, in whatever way. "I don't know this word," the elf squeaked while reading Patrick's homework. "Get me a dictionary." "No, what's even better, look up the word and sound it out by each letter." 6. When it came to maths, Patrick was out of luck. "What are times tables?" The elf shrieked. "We elves never need that. And addition and subtraction and division and fractions. Here, sit down beside me. You simply must guide me. Elves know nothing of human history. To them, it's a mystery." So the little elf, already a shouter, just got louder. "Go to the library. I need books. More and more books. And you can help me read them too." Some new words in the box. Page 10. Nag. One who troubles someone all the time by complaining or asking them to do something. Drag. An informal word. Something dull and uninteresting. Slyly. Secretively. Kid. An informal word. A child. Chores. Work that must be done every day, often boring. Attitude. A feeling about someone or something. 7. As a matter of fact, every day in every way, that little elf was a nag. Patrick was working harder than ever, and was it a drag? He was staying up nights, had never felt so weary, was going to school with his eyes puffed and bleary. 8. Finally, the last day of school arrived, and the elf was free to go. As for homework, there was no more. So he quietly and slyly slipped out the back door. 9. Patrick got his A's. His classmates were amazed. His teachers smiled and were full of praise. And his parents? They wondered what had happened to Patrick. He was now the model kid. Cleaned his room, did his chores, was cheerful, never rude. Like he had developed a whole new attitude. 10. You see, in the end, Patrick still thought he had made that tiny man do all his homework. But I'll share a secret. Just between you and me, it wasn't the elf. Patrick had done it himself.
Learners, you have listened to the story of Patrick, and very interesting. Who made him do the homework? We do not know. But let's understand the story. Myself and Sirith are going to summarize it in 12 pointers. We will alternatively read. Learners, please listen to the summary based on your listening to the story. Fine. Who did Patrick's homework? Patrick did not want to complete his homework because he hated homework and liked to play sports.
One day, Patrick's cat caught an elf and was playing with it.
Then the elf seemed to save from the cat.
The elf promised Patrick that it would grant him a wish and in return.
Learners and Sirith, the story of Patrick and his struggle in doing the homework. Here is the summary of the story. Patrick did not want to complete his homework because he hated homework and he liked to play sports.
One day, Patrick's cat caught an elf and was playing with it.
Then the elf saw Patrick and asked him to save from the cat.
The elf promised Patrick that it would grant him a wish in return.
Patrick agreed and told the elf that he had to complete all Patrick's homework till the end of the semester.
The elf reluctantly agreed, but he told Patrick that he would need his help because the elf did not know how to do homework.
Every day the elf asked Patrick's help by making Patrick to find the words in the dictionary or to add or subtract mathematics problems.
The elf made him to do all the homework.
Finally, on the last day, when the school was over, the elf slipped from the back of the door.
When the results were out, Patrick got A.
His teachers, parents and classmates were surprised and happy to see Patrick's achievements.
Patrick was now become very active in learning and take care of himself.
So he has become an irresponsible boy. Learners, this is the summary of the lesson. This elf was very meticulous in making him do the work. Fine. All right. Learners, let's listen to this story again, because I'm going to give you some serious toss. Okay? Come on, let's listen to it again. Sirith and learners, we have listened to the story twice and the summary has been read out to you. I'm going to put you into some serious task. I'm going to read out some statements. Learners, you have to say whether the statements are true or false. Fine? One. Patrick liked to do homework.
False,
okay. Patrick never liked to do homework.
True.
Patrick liked to do homework sometimes.
False.
He never wanted to do homework. Fine. He found the elf in his house.
True.
Yeah. Then the elf was scared of the cat and asked Patrick to help him to escape.
True.
Patrick asked the elf to do his homework.
True.
Elf did all his homework.
False.
But who did the homework then?
Patrick did all his homework himself.
Elf made Patrick to do all his homework.
True.
Patrick did not know that the elf was making him to do all the homework.
True.
Fine. Patrick got an A in the annual exam.
True.
Elf decided to stay with Patrick forever.
False.
It slipped out of the door the last day. Fine. Learners, this is how sometimes teachers make us to do work. We don't feel that we are doing the work. So, Elf is a great teacher, great mentor also. Now, it has transformed the boy, changed the boy. So, learners, Sirith, you must have got some such experience with your parents or somebody, that
Yes, sometimes I asked my sister to help and she said, I will not do some work if you make all the work and I will just watch TV. So I said, you just arrange the books and I will do reading and all the stuff. So she arranged the books and I read.
So she in a way makes you do the work. Yes. Fine. Yeah. She's the elf in your house. Fine. Fine. All right. Learners, see that another thing we need to learn, learners, that we have to do our work our own, particularly not only the homework, our learning activities, whatever in school or classroom and at home. Fine. Learners, and Sirath, another challenge for you. Here is a series of questions, but they are in multiple choice. I'm going to read out the question with two or four options. You'll have to choose the correct option to get the right answer. Fine. Sirath, ready?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Where did Patrick find the elf? He found it near his study table?
No.
It was lying on the floor?
No.
Then he found it when his cat was playing with it?
Yes.
And his father gave him to play with?
C. He found it when his cat was playing with it.
Fine. What did the elf ask Patrick? A. Elf asked him to be his partner. B. Elf asked him to play with him. Elf asked him to beat the cat. D. Elf asked him to save it from the cat.
D. Elf asked him to save it from the cat.
Fine. What promise did Elf give Patrick? A. It granted him a cricket bat. B. It granted him a wish. C. It gave him lot of toffees. D. It granted him to be free.
B. It granted him a wish.
Fine. What did Patrick ask the elf to do? A. Patrick asked the elf to go away from there. B. He asked the elf to do all his homework. C. He asked the elf to take care of his cat. D. He asked the elf to play with him.
B. He asked the elf to do all his homework.
Fine. 5. How did the elf do the homework? A. Elf did all homework himself. Elf consulted dictionary and did the homework. Elf asked Patrick to do the homework. Elf did not do the homework at all.
C. Elf asked Patrick to do the homework.
What was the reaction of Patrick's teachers, parents and classmates at the end? They were surprised and praised him. They did not believe it. They thought that Patrick cheated in doing the homework and they knew Elf did his homework.
A. They were surprised and praised him.
Fine. Now tell me, learners, it's a very interesting story. Now tell me, who did Patrick's homework? Elf or Patrick?
Patrick did his homework himself.
But what he was thinking?
He was thinking that the elf did his homework.
Fine. Alright, thank you, Sirath and learners. We have done a lot of activities. Look at it. What kind of boy was and is Patrick? I mean, what kind of boy was Patrick before the elf entered in his life and after the elf arrived in his life? This is one. I'll come to that later. We also have to describe these two, make some statements. I'm not going to ask you to write. Learners, just based on the listening and the activities we have done, learners, try and describe Patrick. Come on, Sirath. Sirath is doing for you. Learners, you try yourself.
Patrick was not a good boy because he did not did his homework and liked to play Nintendo and outside games. And his teachers told him to do his homework, but he never liked to do, and he was feeling that he was an ignoramus because he did not do his homework.
Fine. After elf arrived, how he changed? Come on, describe
After him. After the elf arrived, Patrick was totally changed. He did his homework, he did his course, and all his teachers and parents praised him.
Very good, classmates also. Now, learners, look at the transformation. Now, Sirath has said whatever came into her mind. You also can speak out, just simply describe what he was before the elf arrived and what he was, he is, or what he was later. Come on, this is describing a person's behavior. Sirath said he was not a good boy. I wouldn't agree with that. He was a normal boy, but he was lazy. He was not interested in studies. Fine. And this is his. So we also describe the qualities of the person. Sirath, fine. Now, learners, now you take up your pen and paper, your notebook, write 5 to 7 or 8 sentences describing Patrick before the arrival, before the elf came into his life, then 5-6 sentences after the arrival, after the coming of elf in his life. So I expect you do it. We can't see it here on radio, but however, you may please write. We may ask you to, you can, if you want, you can send to me via email, which we'll tell you later. Now, Sirath and the learners there, learners of class 6. Now describe the elf.
The elf was very smart. Hmm. He made Patrick to do his homework.
No. I'm going to stop you here. How was the elf when it was caught up or chased by the cat? He was scared, you know.
Yeah.
Then everything you have to say. Learners, think about it when you do an activity, speaking, put everything, take some time, 10 seconds or 1 minute or even 2 minutes, 2-3 minutes in the classroom. Here we can't do. Just put down the points, then speak. Come on, now, Sirath, say how.
The elf was very scared when he was caught by Patrick's cat, and he saw Patrick coming in the room. So he told Patrick to do to save him from the cat, and he will grant a wish.
Hmm. You have to say the describe the qualities of elf. Hmm.
Then the elf was feeling a little bit of scared, and when he was saved by a cat, the cat, Patrick saved him. So Patrick was
just to describe the qualities of elf. You said clever. Oh, that I want.
He was clever. That he made Patrick to do his homework, and he slipped from the back door.
Once completed, but he was also sincere, yeah, in making him work. So learners, when you describe a person, look at the qualities of the person, both good qualities and not so good qualities. So this is how. Learners, thank you very much, Sirath and learners. We have listened to the story twice. We summarized the story, and we did some true or false and multiple choice questions. This must have made you understand this text. The basic idea is to understand the text. Learners, read the text again. Sirath, you also will do, I believe. Then do the activities at the end of the lesson. There are a lot, and they are comprehension questions. Please do it. Learners, we'll meet you in the second part. Sirath, thank you very much. Keep reading and learning.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants, Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Vandana Arimardhan. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.